Hello everyone, this is Leo from Genoware Press. In this video, we will go over the container options available in Genoware Press and GP Premium. I will be using the options from elements and spacing modules, so make sure you have them activated. We will also be using the Flexbox structure from Genoware Press 3.0 or above. Let's get started and head to Layout, Container. The first option we have is the container width option. The pixel setting here is the overall container width, which includes the padding and sidebar if you're using one. Now let's take a look at the separating space option. If you're using the separate containers layout, then this option adjusts the gray gap you see between each element here. This option will still work even if you're using the one container option. This option groups all the elements into one big block, and the separating space is not as obvious. Let's switch the content layout back to separate containers as I find it easier to show what each option does. Next, we have the content separator slider. This option controls the space between the feature image, title, content, and entry meta. Next, we have the container alignment option. This option allows you to choose how the edge of the box aligns with the header and footer. By default, it's set to text, so these two elements will align. Or we can choose boxes. Now this aligns with the edge of the box. Lastly, we have the content padding option. This option allows you to change the space here. It also has mobile specific option. So these are the customizer options. Next, we'll take a look at the content container option in the layout meta box. This option is useful when you're using a block plugin like Genoware Blocks or Page Builder plugin. Using the default setting means that the container width and content padding options in the customizer will apply. The full width option makes the content container width to 100% of the screen width and removes the content padding so you can have full control using Genoware Blocks or Page Builder. Let's take a look. You can see that the header width remained unchanged. But now the content width is now 100% of the screen width and the padding is removed. This is required if you want to build any full width sections inside your content. Let's take a look at the other option. The contain option simply removes the content padding set in the customizer so you can have full control of the padding using Genoware Blocks or Page Builder. You can see that the padding is removed. But the container width remains what is set in the customizer. We will set it back to default for now. Now, if you want to use the content container option for all the pages or all posts, and don't want to set it individually through each of the page or post, this is when a layout element comes in handy. Let's take a look. So if we want to use the full width setting for all posts, we can choose full width here, go to display rule, add display rule, and choose post. All posts, we can give the element a name, and hit publish. Let's take a look. This is now full width. And this is now full width as well. Let's remove the element and set everything back to default and take a look at the last option we're going to introduce today. So a lot of times the container width looks good if you're using a sidebar layout. But it looks a little bit too wide if we are not using a sidebar layout, let's say for a single post. This is when we can use a layout element again. Let's go ahead and create a new layout element. Go to Content tab and change the content width. Go to Display Rules, Post, All Post, give it a name if we want to. Hit Publish. Now, this container width remains the same. And if we go to a single post, the content part has much narrower width and it looks better. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.